and welcome to SMLKids Remix 14. Thank you so much for joining us today. Now, an interesting fact is that this is the last remix. Next week, we have got Kingdom Builders.
I have another interesting fact. My interesting fact is I'm wearing a Kingdom Builders jumper. How exciting. It all doubles as a mask.
And my interesting fact is that all three of us, we basically become artists over recent weeks and have done a lot of painting. Guess what? For Kingdom Builders.
No way. Oh, I was there.
Well, that's all very interesting. We have got a lot of love for Kingdom Builders, but we are going to start with some worship, but I'm going to pray first. Father God, thank you that you are here with us. And Lord, I pray that you would help us to understand what it is that you're saying to us today. In your precious name, amen. Now, let's worship.
I can see the promised land, though there's pain within the plan. There is victory in the end. Your love is my battle cry. When my fears like Jericho build the walls around my soul. When my heart is overthrown, your love is my battle cry, the anthem for all my life. Every giant will fall, the mountains will move, every chain of the past you've broken in two. All the fear of the lies, we're singing the truth that nothing is impossible with you. With you, there is hope within the fight, in the wars that rage inside. Though the shadows steal the
video where we try and work out what today's story is.
Yeah, so we're going to show you a picture, and it's going to be really, really zoomed in, and you'll have to guess what the picture is, and we'll give you about 8 seconds to do that.
Okay, guys, is everyone ready? Put your hand up if you're ready. Okay, here's the first one. What do we think it is? Can you guess?
Avocado.
Oh, close. Well, what do you think it is?
Is it an orange?
No, it is a light bulb. Good try though, guys. Good try. Because oranges and light bulbs get mixed up all the time. I was fixing my light the other day, put in an orange. Okay, next one. What do we think it is?
Fire.
Oh, okay. Will, what do you think it is?
Is it Fanta and lemonade mixed together?
Okay, we've got fire and Fanta and lemonade mixed together. Boys and girls, what do you think it is? So it is a big ball of fire. It is the sun. Okay, what's our next one? Okay, let's have your guesses.
It's a building of some kind.
A building of some kind. Okay, Will, what do you think it is?
I was going to say, is it a zebra crossing?
Is it a zebra crossing? Okay, well, Will, you are smashing at this game today. Woo! Boys and girls, what do you think it is? Okay, it is a lighthouse.
Ah.
Amazing. And finally, what do we think this one is?
Is it some orange waves?
Some orange waves. Is that like a sea of Fanta and lemonade mixed together?
It could be, but not necessarily.
Okay, Emmy, let's have a sensible guess.
I'm going to guess fire again.
Ooh, is it fire? Drum roll, please. Yes, it is. Amazing. Good guesses, guys.
Okay. Can anybody guess the link between those four pictures? So we had, what did we have? We had a light bulb. We had
the sun.
The sun, a lighthouse, and fire. What's the link?
I've got a thought going. I have a thought. They're all to do with light, aren't they?
Yes.
And there's someone in the Bible who was the light of the world.
Yes.
And that was Jesus. I'm assuming it's to do with Jesus.
Yeah.
I know there's a group of guys who make some light because they dug a hole in the roof. So is it the story of a paralyzed man?
Yeah.
How do you guess that? Every week. It's like, what? That's right. Well, it is the story of the paralyzed man and Jesus being the light of the world. So we are going to find out a little bit more about that in our video. So grab yourself a drink, grab yourself some fajitas, and let's watch.
Stories of the Bible. Jesus heals a paralyzed man. This is Jesus.
Ohio.
Who is the Son of God and the Savior of the world. Jesus did many amazing things. He taught everyone about God's love, healed people from their sickness, and even calmed storms. The news of Jesus had spread all around and many people wanted to come and see what he was doing. No matter where Jesus went, great crowds of people would follow him. Jesus went to his own town and news spread that he was back home.
Ow!
Soon, the house where he was staying was packed. So Jesus began to preach God's word to the people. Meanwhile, some men heard that Jesus was in town. So they decided to take their paralyzed friend to him to be healed, for their friend wasn't able to walk.
Excuse me?
Huh?
But when they got to the house, they couldn't reach Jesus because of the crowd.
Oh, well.
No!
So they went to the roof...
what?
And dug a hole right above Jesus.
We got this.
Then they lowered their friend down into the crowd right in front of Jesus.
Hey, everybody, how's it going?
Jesus saw their faith, so he said, "Son, your sins are forgiven." There were some Pharisees and teachers of religious law in the room, though, and they were horrified that Jesus would say such a thing. They said to themselves, "Who does he think he is? Only God can forgive sins." Jesus knew what they were thinking, so he asked them, "Why do you question this? Is it easier to say to this man, 'Your sins are forgiven,' or 'Stand up, pick up your mat, and walk?"
What?
Jesus went on to say that he would prove to them that he was allowed to forgive sins.
Yeah, right.
And so Jesus said to the paralyzed man, "Stand up, pick up your mat, and go home."
Okay.
So the paralyzed man stood up and picked up his mat. The entire room was stunned as the man walked out through the crowd. All were amazed and praised God, saying, "We've never seen anything like this before." And they believed that God had sent Jesus with the authority to forgive sins and the ability to help the hurting.
I just love that Bible story. And we've been thinking all about how Jesus is the light of the world today. So, boys, what do you think we could learn from today's story?
So, I think that we can learn about how we can be light, a light in the world to our friends and the people around us. Like that man's friends in the story, they made a hole in a roof so that he could see Jesus. And I think that's an extreme example, but we, in everything we do, we can be a light in the world to our friends.
And I think that we can learn that Jesus can do things that we don't think are possible. Like, actually, that man had never walked, but God made him walk, or Jesus made him walk, and that is really, really cool.
So cool. Those are both really good things that we can learn. But why don't you pause this video at home and have a chat about what you think we can learn from this story?
Well, what can we make from a single sheet of paper activity continues today, and we're going to need, for this activity, a sheet of paper. We're going to need some scissors. And we're going to need some tape or something to stick it all together.
Like blue tack. Okay, so we are going to be seeing if our one sheet will do plenty on a paper lantern.
Okay, everyone, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Ready.
Let's go.
And stop. How does everyone get on? I found that quite tricky. Okay. Will, what you got?
Here you go. This is what I've made. Look at this. Love it. It's bouncy. Nice. It's cool.
Nice. Emily, how did you get on?
It's mine.
Quite nice. Nice.
How about you,
okay. So this is what I made. It doesn't work because I accidentally put an orange in instead of a light bulb.
Ha.
Only joking. This is what I made.
Oh, I like the wiggles.
Yeah.
That's very cool. Well done. Mm. Well done, everyone. And I hope you enjoyed making your lanterns at home as well. But before we finish, we've got time for one more worship song. So let's worship together.
I'm a city on a hill. I'm a light in the darkness. Jesus living in me can change the world.
just living in us can change the world. We are a city on a hill. We are a light in the darkness. Jesus living in us can change the world. Let your light shine, let your light shine, let your light shine.
Well, thank you very much for joining us today. We hope you have had some fun. We look forward to seeing you next week, not for a remix, but for Kingdom Builders, which is going to be so exciting. We're looking forward to it. You should be receiving something in the post this week, so look out for that. But before we go, let's pray. Lord God, I thank you that you're with us always. I pray that you'd remind us that you are with us this week and that you are the light of the world and that you can do all things. Amen.